Watching that unfold was a very awkward situation for me in particular, because I knew both parties. At the time, that was my alma mater. That's the Source magazine. You know, like I did my 5 years there. By the time I had left, most of the people that I had came up with had left as well, and the ship was being ran by a completely, you know, different entity. Somebody, you know, was doing things a lot differently than we were. And it didn't surprise me that it went to that level. And, you know, I had taken some initiative and went upstairs to the magazine, and I spoke to them in advance, like, this isn't a good idea. It's just not a good idea. You shouldn't, don't, I mean, just, it's not a good idea. And it fell on deaf ears, because, you know, I don't think, I don't know if people took it as serious as they should have. And then when it turned into the back and forth and things of that nature, you know, a really powerful brand got ruined in the process. First verse, I'm on till I'm on an island. My life's riding on an autobahn, on autopilot. Before I touch dirt, I'll kill y'all. Royce was meant to be happy. You know, just from the minute that I met him, just lyrically, see, even the way he carried himself, he always had a certain hood regalness to him that definitely said, I'm a star. And yeah, and sometimes it doesn't happen for folks the way we'd like it to, but it does happen if you keep at it. And the one thing about Royce is that throughout the trials and tribulations, he never stopped putting the pen to pad. You know, this opportunity wasn't around 5, 6, 7 years ago, and he was still just as good. You know, so people take note of that, especially us over here, because we're very MC driven. And, you know, don't think we weren't paying attention, you know, because we have to. I mean, or this is the business that we're in. With Royce, it was just, I can't even call it a victim. I think it was just definitely a product of the environment in terms of, you know, what was available to him. And independent labels were snatching his projects left and right. And he put out some really strong work with those independent projects, with those independent labels, that wouldn't have been able to work as well with the major. Expectations with the majors are a lot bigger. So, you know, Royce doing something like 150,000 would have deemed a failure to them, but for an independent on an international level, there's benefits to that. I abuse it, take one line, ain't that into it. I am the addiction, air go to mission, to spread my love like a hippie, I'm tripping, words keep flipping. When I first came across STS, I was moved. I was moved because I hadn't heard anything like that. It was a hybrid of that southern pedigree where they're able to balance and just ride over beats and stay in pocket. But then him living out in Philly, he had that Philly MCing pedigree. So when you mesh those two together, you got a pretty deadly combo. So it was listening to this dude have his way with beats. It was over Love Lockdown. It was a freestyle that I had heard. Love Lockdown. It was off Demand More 1, I think, no, 1.2. And when I heard that, I was like, okay, this is crazy. So I spoke to my boy Groove Chambers out of Tree Sound, who had introduced me to him. And Groove sent me something else, and he sent me a song, a complete song. I was like, okay, send me something else. It was another complete song, so I was like, okay, this kid isn't just raw talent, he can actually make records. You know, and I just felt this was somebody I can work with. This is a project that I could take on and just really utilize my years of experience and into turning something with potential into something much bigger. And that's what I'm in the process of doing right now. You know, we've geared up all this work with the past year and a half. We've geared up for the release of this project we're about to put out called The Illustrious. And it's a great project. It's a reflection of what he's capable of being. We pulled out the stops, and we've got great production from Alchemist, Emil, Ski Beats, Schoolboy Vic. We got appearances by Yellow Wolf, Farnsworth Bentley. You know, it's like, even in putting this together, we treated it like an album. That's why it's a free album. So it's been quite a journey. It's still, you know, the early stages of it, but it's, he is a reflection of the times where you have to be as self-sufficient as possible. I found STS at his raw stage. He had already made a run through the business with a couple of producers here and there. Nobody knew really what to do with him. I know that he was formerly signed at Def Jam with a duo, personally signed by Jay-Z. And as soon as Jay-Z left, you know, he was paid to, they gave him a nice little, you know, thank you very much check, and he became a free agent. And at that time, he just started venturing off into Soloville, and that's when I caught him. And I caught him at that stage where I had to ask myself, okay, like, am I ready to do this? Am I ready to take on a new artist on my own, independent, you know, without, you know, a major label backing? Can I develop this into something? I said to myself, yeah, because, you know, it's one thing for people in my business to preach and say something. It's another thing to do it. And in this case, this was almost like an experiment, but it's way beyond an experiment at this point. Now it's a priority. Like every great artist with raw potential, you have to rough the edges out. And he's one of the few artists that I've been working with that all you've got to do is provide him the resources and take it, and it'll work itself out. I don't find myself in the studio too much doing the do this, do that. Nah, the kind of development that I managed to do with him is just real life business development, where it's like when we do a radio run, you know, it's like, okay, sell this, tell them that, here's some key pointers. And what's happening is it's all my 15 years in the business as a music journalist and as an A&R being put to work on this one act. So it's definitely quite the experience, I gotta tell you. It's not easy. I gotta really pay close attention on what record folks are connecting with regarding him, you know, regarding STS. Where it's like, okay, they like this one, but they didn't like this one. Okay, who was it that didn't like this one and why? Well, they're a certain demographic, they're not really into it. Okay, cool, how can we go get him? Which is the big reason why I took on STS. I think he's the most multifaceted, one of the most multifaceted MCs I've ever met. There's no limit to what he's able to do. If he wanted to get gun heavy, he could. It's not his cup of tea. If he wanted to get pound for pound lyrical with the best of them, I know he could. And it's just putting out the kind of music that reflects that. So that's what we're trying to do. Illustrious.